How many of you have taken an art class before and realized that drawing wasn't your strongest skill compared to others? Well, that's actually quite normal because, like any skill, it takes constant practice in order to improve that. My cultural artifact today is my t-shirt from the National Art Honor Society, which I was a former member of. During my high school years, I was a member for 4 years, and during those years I also enrolled in various levels of art classes in order to improve my art skills. And when we think of art, we think of famous artists such as Leonardo da Vinci or Van Gogh, but the art that we produce shouldn't be compared to theirs because we're not all talented artists like them. And that's actually quite normal, but we shouldn't let that discourage us from attempting to create art in order to express ourselves. Although art is not a skill that many people approve of, specifically schools that tend to cut off art fundings or any type of art, it is a useful skill that allows us to express ourselves when words aren't able to do that. And for the first half of my speech, I'll be giving a brief history about what the National Art Honor Society is and how it associates with the art culture. And the second half of my speech, I'll be describing how I associate myself with the club to represent the art culture. And according to the official website of the National Art Honor Society, the program was first funded in 1978 by the National Art Education Association in order to give students the opportunity to show off their work and give them recognition for their talented artwork. You did not have to be an art fanatic to join the club at all, as long as you were willing to give time to the club, such as participating at events and showing off the artwork that you created. Not only did they offer different opportunities that students could take advantage of, but they also gave scholarships to those who applied, and the only requirement was that you had to be a member of them. There's no specific requirement to it. And with that, at the events that you were able to participate in, you got to meet new people and become more part of the community that you were helping out and bringing awareness to art. Another fact is that, according to the official website, that they reached a record-breaking amount of students of 49,000 between the year 2014 and 2015. Just to go more into the shirt, it's solid black shirt, but with their logo, the National Art Honor Society. And the word art in the middle stands out because of the bright colors. So that clearly makes people more aware of what this shirt is. And the only reason you were able to get this shirt was if you became a member of the club. There's no other way you could have gotten the shirt. And you also got a tassel for graduation, which was a different color from every other student's. So that gave recognition to the students that were members of this club and gave them a sense of pride and proudness of being different to the other students that weren't. I identify myself with this culture because I used to not like art at all. I used to think that it was boring and that I was no good. My art could easily be confused for elementary schools. And after several times of taking art classes, I began to improve, and I thought that I should take it more seriously. By my third year of taking art class, I changed that, and I started asking for more help about it, and I decided to enroll into AP Art in order to improve more. My friends thought I was crazy for doing that because they saw my artwork before, and they thought that I was just going to fail the course, because I wasn't ready. But I thought that I should still join in order to improve and accept the challenge of that. I knew that it was going to be a difficult task, but I was willing to do it. I'm a former member because club is only open to students that are from kindergarten to 12th grade, and there's no other association with it after high school. But I continue to do artwork as a choice on my free time, in order to ventilate any feelings that I have and express my feelings by trying whatever I see on the in front of my eyes or what I feel. And not only do I do it, but other people can. There's a program known as Art Therapy that helps with this. Anyone that has life-changing moments, children or adults, use this program in order to help improve their self-esteem that was brought down and to cause the stress that any of them went through. Art's for everyone. You don't have to be good at it. You don't have to be bad at it. As long as you produce it yourself. Yeah, most people think it's not an important skill to learn, but it is useful in order to help yourself, express yourself in different ways. And hopefully everyone gives it a try when you can.